welcome back. In today's video, I wanted to share some tips on how to take care of your clothing so that they last longer. With a capsule wardrobe, one of the challenges that I had is making sure that my clothes lasted longer and looked newer over a longer period of time. When shirts were dingy or didn't look as new as I wanted them to be, I used to just buy a new shirt without even thinking twice about, well, why don't I just take better care of the clothing that I already have? And obviously with a smaller wardrobe, like a capsule wardrobe, you're wearing your pieces more often, which also means that you're gonna have excess wear and tear. So these simple tips have really helped my clothes just look newer and last longer over longer periods of time, even if they're not like the best quality clothing to begin with. Because I'm taking the time to take care of them, this has made a world of a difference. And it's just crazy when I look back and I'm like, I was not doing this stuff before, even though they are like really simple tips. But hopefully this video can help you too, especially if you're just diving into the idea of a capsule wardrobe or you just want to take better care of the clothing pieces that you already own. The first three tips kind of have to do with the way you wash your clothes. Number one is you want to make sure you wash in cold water. This is because hot water ends up wrinkling and shrinking your clothes. When you think about it, you like cook food in like hot boiling water. Imagine doing that to your clothes every single week. That hot water, it might not be boiling, but it's obviously going to cause a lot of wear on the fabrics and fibers of your items. Washing with cold water will not only save your clothing, but it also saves energy and money. The next tip has to do with how often you wash your clothes. When it comes to jeans specifically, you do not have to wash your denim every single time you wear it. In fact, you want to go a couple wears and then wash them, because if you are washing your denim every single week or every single time you wear it, that's going to end up wearing out the quality and fabric of the denim. The next tip has to do with the detergent that you use. For one, you want to try to use an eco-friendly detergent, because that's not only healthier for you, but it's safer for the environment. And also use less detergent, because the more detergent you use, especially if it's like a toxic, just horrible one, it's going to end up eating away at your clothing, making it look more dull. The eco-friendly detergent option that I've been using are the Tree Earth Eco Strips. I absolutely love how simple it is to use these. I just pop them in the wash first and then I put in my clothes, and it just eliminates the mess that comes with like me like pouring in the detergent. It also isn't made with a lot of the toxic ingredients that a lot of detergents are made out of, which not only will save the fibers on your clothes but also your skin. So it's paraben free, it's vegan, and it's also hypoallergenic, so it's a lot more healthier for you, and not to mention it's way more healthier for the environment. For example, you won't have to stack up on the plastic detergent gallons that may not always end up in the recycling bin, and you just cut back on waste, but you can also protect yourself as well. So I have them in both the fragrance-free and the fresh linen. I prefer the fragrance-free, but like I said, these have just been a lifesaver for me. I like how easy they are, and they're fuss-free, but there's so many good benefits that come out of using them. The next tip is to rotate your clothing. You want to make sure you give your clothing a break every once in a while, whether it's storing it away for different seasons or different trends. This is not only a good practice to help your clothes last longer, but it's also just a good minimalist wardrobe practice in general, because when you store your clothes away, even if it's just like at the back of your closet or in a box, and then you pull them out for the next season, it kind of like curbs your appetite to want to go shopping, because you shopped your closet, you haven't seen those pieces in a while, and you're excited to wear them again. I love doing this because where I live we have all four seasons, so I will go like months without wearing my summer stuff, so when it's time to pull it out I get excited again, and I don't have like the urge to just buy a bunch of new pieces because I fall in love with the pieces that I already have once again. The next tip is to hang dry your clothing. I cannot believe I was not doing this before, but this will definitely improve the quality of your clothing, because dryers will weaken the natural fabrics, or just the fabric in general, of your clothing pieces. And honestly, they're evil. They can shrink, they can stretch, they mess up the shape of your clothing. So if you can, hang dry your clothes. So a few tips that I have when you're air drying your clothes is to, one, get a nice little separate rack that you can use for air drying. I have this nice little clothing rack from IKEA, and also wash in smaller loads. Sometimes I'll try to stuff like a giant load in the wash, and then I try to hang dry it, but I don't have enough room like on the rack, so the clothing ends up taking a long time to dry, which is not good at all. So I tend to separate my laundry into different color groups, and then I wash and dry the different color groups so that way everything can dry at a reasonable amount of time. Next tip is to store your clothes the right way. For one, you want to make sure you avoid like the wire or the plastic hangers because they kind of stretch out your clothing. Instead, opt for wood or velvet. I like to use velvet hangers. Now, another thing to keep in mind is the actual size of the hanger. I'm petite, so the like normal size hangers are actually too big for my clothes. They tend to stretch out the shoulders and all the clothing. So I actually get the little kid hangers from Amazon because they're better fitted for the size of my clothing. Another thing to keep in mind when storing your clothes is not to hang your sweaters. Make sure you just go ahead and fold them. I got this cute little like, well, I'm not even gonna show you guys it because it's like deep in my closet, but it is like a basket container from IKEA, and I just put all my sweaters and fold them up in there because hangers will mess up the shape of the sweater and it's like constantly drooping. So if you live in a climate like I do with extreme winter and extreme summer, you don't want those sweaters sitting there on the hangers for months just messing up the shape. In fact, even when I like film videos and I have to like put the sweaters on the hangers, I'm low-key cringing in the inside because I'd rather have it nice and folded up in like a little case in my closet. Last but not least is to ditch the iron and go for a steamer. I don't even know if I should explain this, but a metal plate, a hot metal plate up against the fabric of your clothing, what is that going to do? I know that like sometimes we end up messing up our clothes when we iron anyway, put weird marks in them and so on. So instead of that, opt for a steamer. If you can't get a steamer, you can always use like the steam option on your iron. That's what I do. And instead of letting the hot iron plate hit my clothes, I let the steam kind of let it out. But honestly, when I air dry my clothes the right way, I really don't have to do a lot of ironing because making sure they're like hanging when they're air drying works just as well. So that completes today's video. I hope one of these tips can help you make sure you're taking the best care of your clothes. As I mentioned in the beginning, these are some pretty simple tips. I mean, these were things that I honestly wasn't doing a few years ago, and I'm glad that now that I am doing them, I have seen that my clothes just look nicer even though I've had them for years because I'm taking better care of them. It's also a good practice because you learn to like be content with what you have instead of like when something looks a little old, you just go and get a new one. You're really focusing on taking care of the pieces you already have. Don't forget to subscribe for more Capsule Wardrobe content, and I will see you all next week.